Maybe you all stand at this time as the family come in. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anoint my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely, and I say surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Let the people of God say amen.
Amen.
Come on, if there's some sanctified folks in here, say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You may be seated at this time. We bless the Lord on today. We thank God for this day, even in spite of what is going on as we sit here and celebrate the life of our brother Donald Alston Sr. We still thank God because the Bible says that I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Amen. We want to definitely keep the family in our prayers because losing a loved one is not easy. It is, come on somebody, give me some feedback. It is not easy losing a loved one. We just want to thank God that we're able to be here and celebrate our brother on today. And we're not going to hold you. We're going to move along with the program of our service, but we want to lift up the name of Jesus too. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We thank the Lord. At this time, we're going to have an opening song by our sister Melanie. Amen.
Amen. Amen. God is good. Yes, sir. I know your family don't know me. Sister Moet called me, and we fiddled around a little bit, her and auntie and I, and it felt like we were out, that she was my little sister, and I just felt right at home and at ease with them. I just wanted to greet you and tell you that I'm sorry for your loss.
Yes.
I know how you're feeling. I just lost my brother suddenly last month.
Jesus.
And then I have another brother who is clinging to life as we speak. So, and my mother is 84 years old, so I know what you're going through. My prayers are with you. I've been praying for you. And I just pray that from this day forward that you guys will just love on each other, because we don't know. Everybody got to go this way. We all got to have our turn. But the most important part is that you're ready to meet the master when he comes and he calls your name. Because heaven is real. And we are. He is going to crack that sky. And we have to be ready. It doesn't matter the day. We don't even know whether he's coming morning, night, or noon. He can come and take us back. The whole thing is just to be ready when he comes. So my first opening song, I'm just going to sing the song, Break Every Chain.
Yes.
You want the chains of darkness to be broken. We want the chain of murdering to be broken.
Yes,
we want the spirit of sadness and sorrow to be broken. That's my song.
Yes, Jesus.
There is power.
Come on now.
In the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Yes, Jesus. Thank you.
He'll break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Come on now.
So there is power in the name of Jesus. He could do anything. There is power in the name of Jesus. I'm telling you right now, there is power in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. I don't care what you're going through, he'll break every chain, break every chain. break every chain. There's an army rising up. We are that army. There's an army rising up. There is an army rising up, yeah. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Oh, yes, it will. He'll break every chain. There's an army rising up. We are that army. There's an army rising up. Yeah, yes. There is an army rising up. Yeah. To break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain.
Yes,
we gotta do it in the spirit. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Chains of loneliness. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Chains of sadness. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. Destroy it, Lord, destroy. Chain, break every chain, break every chain, Lord, break chains, Lord, break,
yes, Lord,
chains, Lord, break,
yes,
chains, Lord, break, chains, Lord, break every chain, break every chain, break every.
Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Break every chain, break every chain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We thank the Lord. Thank you, our sister Melanie. We thank you for that wonderful selection of Break Every Chain. I don't know about you, but I want every chain in my life to be broken. Come on, somebody. If I could just get one person to agree with me on today, I'll be all right. Break every chain. We thank the Lord on today. We bless the Lord on today. Right now, we're going to have our scripture reading. I'm going to be reading into your hearing the Old Testaments, which is Psalms 34 and 18. And then we're going to jump over to the New Testament reading, which is Matthew 5 and 4. Psalms 34 and 18, it reads as follow, and this is the reading or the writing of David, King David. And he said, the Lord is nigh unto them that of a broken heart. How many of us have a broken heart on today, losing our loved one on today? As the sister said, that she lost a couple of people in her lives. I buried my father in February. I buried my father. So that pain is still hurting. But we know that God is able. And this scripture right here, it comforts us. I don't want to get to preaching right now, but the Bible says that the Lord is nigh to the broken hearts. So just come nigh to him, draw nigh unto him, and he'll draw nigh unto you. And it says, and he saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. God is good all the time. There's never a time when God is not good. Even in our bad, God is still good. Because the Bible says that all things will work together. Come on, somebody. I'm getting happy up here, but all things will work together for the good of them. But you gotta love the Lord. And that's the only benefit that we can have. But there's many benefits, but that's another benefit that we can have. Even though we are celebrating our brother Donald here, we know that he is in a far better place than us. He ain't gotta worry about the troubles of this world no more. Come on, somebody. God is good all the time. That's the old folks used to say, God is good and all the time. God is good. We bless the Lord. Family, we are here. We're grieving with you. We're praying for you that God bless you and that he is there for you. Matthew 5:4 says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Let's go back further. Listen, it says, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. How many of us need some comfort right about now? Come on, somebody. We bless the Lord on today. We thank God for those scripture reading on today. Thank you, sister. Okay, we got Sister Melody is coming back up. Come on, let's give her a hand clap of love as she come up here and sing to the glory of God. Amen.
How many of you know that whatever's going on, we may not be able to stop, because God told us what? The battle is not yours.
It's not even ours.
It belongs to him.
It belongs
so you need to just stand still, see the salvation of the Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
Stand still and know that he is still God.
Yes.
No matter what we're going through, God is still there. He has not left us. He said
never.
That he will never leave us nor forsake
never.
Us. And I'm clinging on to that today.
Yes,
if there's anybody in here that is hopelessness, that has
Jesus.
Hopelessness, give it to Jesus.
It
he
to
told
Jesus.
Us to cast all of our cares
come
on him.
On,
that
on.
Means everything that we're concerned about, give it to Jesus.
It to Jesus.
Some people say, I don't know how to pray. Well, it's just like you're talking to your friend.
That's
you
it.
Just get yourself to aside, get quiet, and just...
Yeah, Lord.
In a quiet room and say, listen, Lord, I need you.
I need you.
And whatever it is you want to say to him, whatever it is you want to tell him, talk to him. Tell him all about it.
Yes.
The song that says, have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about your troubles. You don't have to just tell him about what troubles you. You can just ask him, Lord, I have my mother and my sisters and my siblings. Lord, I need something I need for you to fix.
Yes.
It don't even have to be a troublesome thing. But it might be something that you're in need of. God said he will supply the need.
Come
God
on.
Said he already knows what you have need of before you even ask. But even so, he's still that kind of God that he wants you to ask him. He's already working before you even start asking
come
him.
On, Jesus.
So just know that the battle is not yours.
It's not
it
yours.
Belongs to God. Hallelujah. According to his purpose.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The battle is not yours. It is the Lord's. Have you ever thought about that for a moment? Even before you take a punch, swing a punch in the spiritual realm, the battle is not yours. It's already won.
Already won.
The Bible tells us to stand still. Stand still. We ain't got to fight this battle. God knows all that we're going through. And that's the good thing about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He went through everything that we're going through right now. He felt the pain of this life. But we got to give it over to Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, our sister. Sister Melanie, we thank God for you. The battle is not yours. Amen. At this time, we're going to be blessed with the reading of the cards and the obituary by our sister, Nicole Smith, at this time.
To the Alston family, I bring greetings from my family, the Smith family. Mo and I go back a long time. Monique, Mo's been my hairdresser for over 25 years. And when your friends call, you know, my grandmother used to always say, you show yourself friendly.
That's right.
And I said, Mo, I'll be right there, whatever you need me to do. Okay, there was many cards and condolences and texts and things that came to the family, but the family will acknowledge many of them at a later time, okay? Sending love and thoughts and prayers to your family during this tough time. The English, HR, and OH team. You're in our thoughts and prayers. We are shared in your sadness and losing someone so special. Wishing you the blessing of peace, the comfort of warm memories now and in the time ahead. From Mustaine and Miss Yvonne. With deepest sympathy and to your family, there is an unbroken thread that is woven from love. And it keeps family always together, for nothing as real as the moments we shared. They live on in our memories. Diane, as difficult as this time is, may you find comfort in knowing that your loved one will always be with you, and the memories you share will forever be a part of your life. You're in my prayers, Karen. Special memories of your father will always live in your heart. Miss Di, why nothing is harder than saying goodbye to someone you love. May you find strength in knowing your father will be a part of you forever. With heartfelt sympathy, I am so sad to hear of the loss. I pray you will find peace with the memories of his love. Sincerely, Diane. At this time, I will also read the obituary. In love and memories of Donald Alston, served sunrise February the 2nd, 1937, sunset May 9th, 2022. Homegoing memory service, Saturday, May 28th, 2022. Memorial service, 1 p.m. Jason Lloyd Funeral Home. Goodbye are only for those who love with their eyes. Because for those who love with heart and soul, there is no such thing as separation. The life story of Donald Alston Sr. Donald Alston Sr., loving father, grandfather of four generations, brother, uncle, and friend, peacefully passed away at the age of 85 on May 9th, 2022. Donald Sr. was born February the 2nd, 1937, in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He was educated in the Philadelphia public school system and became a construction worker. Thereafter, a career in oil industry. Some of his favorite hobbies was enjoying a good baseball game. His back in the day, westerns and other movies classic in the comfort of his home. He loved cooking when he had the chance, as we remembered him for country neck bones, ham, lima beans, and his homemade delicious bread pudding. He never shared that recipe. Donald loved his entire family all the same and deeply cherished his great-grandchildren. It really brought a smile to his face when we all visit him with our children and to see his other family members. His known affection was grinning while squeezing our cheeks and playing with our ears. Ouch! Dad had a special nickname for everyone he loved. Today, the life of Donald is spiritually shared with family and friends. He was born to parents Samuel and Helen Harris Alston, both deceased. He leaves to cherish his memories to his children, Donald Jr., twins David, deceased, and Donald and Donna, Damon, Dwight, Deborah, Diane, their sister, Roxanne, and his ex-wife, Roseanne Alston. His grandchildren, Dawn, Dana, Little Donald, Diane, Mo, Andre, Annie, Maurice, Nadir, and Kyrie, and a host of great and great-grandchildren. He also leaves to love to his baby sister, Thelma Boyd, and a host of cousins, nieces and nephews. Preceded in death, his sister, Anna Mae Alston, Helen Taylor, Blanche Piner, and brothers, Benjamin Alston, James Harris, and Samuel Alston, and brother-in-laws, James Piner and Carrie Boyd. Our family poem, Our Broken Chain. We knew that evening God was calling his name. In life we love you dearly, and death we feel the same. It broke our hearts to lose you. You didn't go alone. For part of us went with you the day God called you home. You left us peaceful memories. Your love is still our guide. Although we cannot see you at our side, our family chain is broken and nothing seems the same. But as God called us one by one, the chain will link again. With love, your children. To everything there is a season and a time, to every purpose under the heavens. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. Thank you for all of your prayers, your cares, and sincere help during this time. The family appreciate the love that you have shown. Sincere and warm wishes, the Alston family.
Amen. At this time, we're going to open up the floor for remarks. And let's be 2 minutes, please. The family requested 2 minutes for remarks. And those of you that want to give remarks, you can come at this time. Amen. Come on, I know there's somebody want to talk about that bread pudding. That caught my attention. He said, Pop know how to cook, huh? Mm-hmm. And he never gave up that recipe, huh? So everybody holding on to that secret, huh? Come on, and say how good my brother Donald was up here. Just to say he was a good man or something. Or he had a good, I sat around and watched the Phillies game. Amen. God bless you.
Good afternoon. Like I said, I love my uncle and glad to see all my family. I had a lot of memories, but We saved them for a later date. Right. I'm just glad my ears. I haven't been able to hear right since he's been playing with my ears since I was a little guy, you know. That's the only little story I want to share with y'all, but I'll share some other stories when y'all have some other time. Anybody else? I ain't taste that bread pudding you talking about.
Oh, no?
Yeah. Oh, they can cook. Our family can cook, man.
Amen.
That's
amen.
Pastor, if you don't mind, I just want to, something just came in my spirit, if you don't mind me sharing with you. In times like these,
come on, Jesus.
We need an anchor. In times like these, we need
afternoon. And once again, we are praying for the family. We pray in God's comfort in your life. Death is a hard thing, but it's not the end. Come on, somebody. It's not the end. And we thank God for all of you. We thank God for our sister Melanie, and we thank God for our sister Nikki that read the obituary. We just want to say to Monique, I know the family through Monique, and I've known Monique for years now, and we thank God for you. We're praying for you, Monique. And you know that we are here for you. It's never a time that you cannot call or text us. And we will definitely pray for you. Today we want to hear what thus says the Lord. We want to bring your attention to a very familiar passage of scripture. And I'm going to read into your hearing two verses. And it's found in the 11th chapter of John. And this is Jesus speaking to Martha and Mary. Jesus said to her, and this is the NIV translation. Jesus said to her, he says, I am the resurrection and the life. He said, the one who believes in me will live. Even though they may die, they will live. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Then he asked the question, do you believe this? And Martha replied, she said, yes, Lord. I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, who has come into this world. And that is the reading, thus says the Lord. We thank the Lord on today. Now, God, as we minister to your people, Lord, speak to me, speak through me, and speak for me by the power that's invested in me. And it is the Holy Spirit of the living God. Lord, I thank you on this day, God. God, we asking you to comfort this family, God. But right now, God, somebody needs to hear your word, God. Lord, give them a receptive heart. Give them a receptive heart, a receptive ear right now, so they can hear what the Lord has to say for their day today, God. We thank you right now. Hide me behind that powerful cross of Jesus, because there is power in that name. And we thank you on this afternoon. We count it a privilege even to stand in your presence, God. So we thank you right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we say amen.
Amen.
Amen. The text on today, and I want you to go home with this, living to live again. We are living to live again. My brothers and my sisters, we are living in a time where life is very fragile. It's very fragile. I remember there when I was younger, when they used to say, we are here today and going tomorrow. But life now is so fragile where you can say you're here today and gone today. Have I got a witness out there? Life is so fragile, so it is very, look at your neighbor and say, it's very, very important how we live our lives. We only got one life. Amen. It is important how we spend this life down here on earth that God has so graciously blessed us with. It is important how we love each other and how we love on each other every single day. We don't want to be no part-time lovers. Come on, somebody. It is so important how each day that God wakes us up to thank him for brand new mercies every single day. Do you not know that there are 8 billion people in this world and millions of people did not hear that alarm clock this morning? Somebody ought to get happy because God put breath in your life. It wasn't that alarm clock. It wasn't the smell of coffee. It wasn't the smell of bacon. It was the good God graciously blessing you, waking you up this morning. There was a soap opera and preached a sermon a funeral ago, and there was a soap opera that my mother used to watch, and it used to be called One Life to Live. You got one life, and there was a soap opera that my mama watched so every single day. One life to live. We only have one life on this side, so I say to every one of you to make the most of the time that God has blessed you with. It's time out for the nonsense. It's time out for the backstabbing and the hating on each other, because life itself is hard enough. You got families bickering, not speaking of this one, not speaking of that one, rolling their eyes, sucking their teeth at that one. Life itself is hard enough. And now you got to bicker with each other. Job said it best. He said, man that is born of woman, full of trouble in a few of days. If you read in the book of Job, you will see that Job himself, he experienced many troubles in his life. Job lost his sons, lost his daughters, they were killed, even his servants, and he lost all his animals and his land. So Job knew what it was and how it felt to go through some troubles in his life. He knew firsthand, and if we look at our world today, there's trouble all around us. There's senseless killings in our city streets. We're living in troubled times. It's like every day you hear on the news, that's another shooting in our city. Our young people are being killed at an unprecedented rate. Families are being destroyed. And death itself don't discriminate. Death don't discriminate on how old you are. If God bless me to see September, I'll be 50 years old. I can be gone today. I'm here today and gone today. When it's your time to go, it's your time to go. Death don't care how much money you got either. There's a lot of people in that ground with millions of dollars in that bank account, but they can't do nothing with it. You can't take it with you. So we're still, we just got trouble all around us. We're living, we're still in the midst of a pandemic that killed over 7 million people. Just this past week, we've seen a supermarket shooting. We've seen a school shooting and a church shooting. We are living in some troubled times. And now we're here on today celebrating the life. That's a good picture right there, too. The life of our brother, Donald Alston Sr. Where's Donald Alston Jr.? Is he? Oh, brother, my man. How you doing, brother? That's good. You, man, you look just like your father. Yeah, I should have known that. Good to meet you. And now we're here. I hope this is, listen, I'm not the first one to tell you, and prayerfully, I'm not the last one to tell you, that life ain't but a vapor. We all have to go down this road. We all have to go down this road. Hebrews 9 and 27 tells us that it's appointed to man to die once. And after that, you know, it comes to judgment. We all have an appointment with death. Y'all know how we skip those doctor's appointments, those dental appointments. But you can't skip that appointment with death. When it's your time to go, it's your time to go. But here's the thing. God knew that on February the 2nd, 1937, he knew that our beloved Donald Alston Sr. would be born. God knew that he would be a loving father, a loving grandfather, a loving brother, uncle, and friend. God even knew that he would love baseball. He knew that he would love them Westerns. And now that I just found out, he knew that he would be able to cook that bread pudding. Could you imagine our brother Donald up there stirring up some bread pudding for those up there walking the streets of gold? Come on, somebody. Y'all ought to get happy. I don't know about y'all, but even though I lost my father is in a far better place. Maybe him and brother Donald is up there high-fiving and they're seeing their master, Jesus Christ. God told Jeremiah that even before he was in his mother's womb, that he knew him. Let me skip on down because y'all looking at me funny. Yeah. Pastor, get to the point. But we all got to leave here. But we need an insurance package. And on today, I want to let you know that there's an insurance package that when you leave this earth, you can still live again. Now, every one of us loves some good insurance. How many of us love some good insurance? Come on, somebody. Whether it's Blue Cross, Blue Shield, Aetna, Cigna, Humana, whatever the case may be. Allstate, Geico, State Farm, or Liberty Mutual. But this insurance that I'm talking about, come on, somebody, that you don't got to worry about it expiring. You don't got to worry about the cost. There's no copay, because it's been all paid in full. But the only requirement that you must meet is just simply accept it. You got to simply accept this insurance package that God himself can only offer. Now, some of you you're wondering, because I see your eyes behind those masks. You're wondering, Pastor, what is this insurance package? What are the requirements? What am I signing up for? And who can give it to me? How can I get this insurance package? Well, I'm glad you asked, because I have the answer. Now, before you sign up, and for those of you who already signed up, say hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me give you some background to this text. This is a pivotal point in Jesus' ministry, because other than his resurrection, this shows that he has the power over death. Here we have Lazarus, the brother of Mary and Martha, who was sick, and he later died. The grieving Martha said to Jesus, she said, Lord, if you would have been here, my brother would not have died. But Jesus said to her, hold up, lady. Hold up, woman. You got it twisted. Do you know who I am? Jesus said to her, it was good that I wasn't here. He wanted to show her, and he wanted to show us, that he has the power over physical death and spiritual death. Oh, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. And he wanted to bring glory to God's name. Jesus shows that neither death nor time is an obstacle to him. Amen. Jesus tells Martha, he said, your brother will rise again. Have I got a witness out there? And Martha said, wait a minute, Jesus. That conversation went like this. She said, yeah, I know he will rise again, but it's in the resurrection. She said, on the last day, yeah, I know he will rise again. She believed in the resurrection, but she didn't think it would happen today.
Yeah, come on now.
I can imagine Jesus saying, wait a minute, woman, wait a minute. Don't, like I said, don't get it messed up. She said, he said, do you know who I am? Mm-hmm. I'm Jesus. Mm-hmm. He said, I'm the same man that walked on water. Mm-hmm. Come on, somebody. Come on. I'm the same one that gave sight to the blind. Yeah. Come on, somebody. I'm the same one that got fed 5,000 people with just two fish and five pieces of bread. Man, listen, that's like taking a whole box. That's like taking a three pieces of chicken, Popeye's chicken, because y'all don't like KFC. Y'all look like Popeye's. That's like taking three pieces of Popeye's chicken and a biscuit and trying to feed everybody in here. Jesus said, listen, wait a minute. I am the resurrection and the life. Jesus was telling Martha that your brother will rise today. Why? Because I have the power to raise up your brother. I have the power of the resurrection and of the life, and it's all in my hand.
Yes, 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 yes.
Jesus is the source of our life.
Yes.
Now watch this. I'm going to get out your way. It's getting good to me up here, Sister Mo. But he said, listen, Martha said, but Lazarus, watch this. He was dead for 4 days. Yeah, he was stinking, sister. But that didn't stop Jesus. The Bible says that there was a big stone in front of the grave where Lazarus was laid, but that didn't stop Jesus. All Jesus had to do was what? Say the word. Jesus commanded the onlookers to remove the stone. Now, Jesus could have removed the stone all by himself, but there are some things that God himself wants you to remove out of your life.
Come on,
somebody. Because faith without works is what? It's dead. Come on, I got some believers out there. We have to come to Jesus and believe who he is. And Jesus said he is a rewarder of those that diligently. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. I need about five of you just to say, remove that stone. Jesus called out Lazarus to come forth. Lazarus came forth. Jesus showed Martha, and he's showing us that the resurrection is not an event. The resurrection is a person, and that person is Jesus himself. Jesus showed his power over physical death. And just like he raised up Lazarus physical, he has the power to raise anybody out of their spiritual death. But what we need to understand, that death is a separation. Yes, we will hurt. Yes, we will miss our brother Donald. But this is not the end. Death is not the period. It's a comma. Because there's something after this death. If I'm not mistaken, Biggie Smalls sang a song. He said there is life after death. You got to understand that there is a life after death. But it's up to you when you choose to go. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. We were all spiritually dead. Many of us been spiritually dead for years. Walking around dead. Y'all remember? Yeah, we like the walking dead. Y'all see that movie? I'm a preacher. I like to walk. He said he walking around dead. But the thing about it is, it's just like how on that movie, The Sixth Sense. And Cole was like, man, I see dead people. You see dead people walking all around, but they're spiritually dead. You're physically walking around, but you're spiritually dead. Because a spiritually dead person is a person without Jesus.
Yes.
Second Corinthians, Paul said to Colossians, I'm sorry, not Corinthians, Colossians. He said in Colossians 2:13, he said that we were dead because of our sins. I don't care how good you look, how fancy you dress up, how good you smell, we were all dead. Because sin, now don't blame it on me because y'all looking at me funny. It wasn't me, it was Adam. And humanity brought on that sin curse. And we all were born because the Bible says that all have sinned and come short of God's glory. Let me close this thing out. But it was God that made us alive. Jesus And he forgave us for all of our sins. And thanks be to God for the love of God that sent his son Jesus to die on the cross so that we can have a new life in Jesus Christ. And what we need to understand is that our body will experience death, but our soul will live forever. But death has no dominion over you and I. But that's only if you are in Jesus. Because Jesus, who is life, Jesus, who gave life, defeated death at the cross. Not only did he defeat death at the cross, he didn't stop there, because my Bible declares that 3 days later he defeated death at the grave. If you go looking for that tomb right now, it's an empty tomb, and because that empty tomb is empty, you and I have life, but it's only in Jesus Christ. So since Jesus was raised from the dead, those who are in Jesus will never die. Yes, we will be hurt. Yes, we will feel pain. But this body that we live in is not eternal. But the only way you can have this life is if you give your life to Jesus Christ. You will live again. But you gotta accept and receive that insurance package. Is there anybody here that had that blessed assurance that Jesus is mine? Oh, what a foretaste and glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation. I've been purchased by blood, born of the Spirit. Is there anybody here that can say, Pastor, I have insurance? Not only do I got insurance, but I got good insurance, because when I leave here, there's a place called heaven, where the streets are paved with gold, where there's a mansion for me and a mansion for you. Is there anybody here that can say, I'm living to live again? I'm living to live again. Shout it, yes. Shout it, yes. Because soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. I don't know about you. I can't answer for you. But one good morning, when this life is over, I'll fly away. Shout it, yes. I'm living to live again. Now watch this. No one gets to the Father but through Jesus. He said, anyone, if you try to come in, yeah, I'm out of shape now. I've got to lose some weight. Woo! Listen, you got to understand that our brother Donald, he is gone. Do it hurt, brother? Yeah. Yes, it hurts. Yeah. I know your pain. I know you're hurt. But one day, if we live to live again, we're going to see him one day. The old folks used to sing a song. They used to say, by and by.
Yes,
when the morning come, when all the saints are come together at home, we will
tell the story,
how we overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by. Hallelujah. We thank God for the life of our father, grandfather, uncle, brother, and friend. Donald Alston Sr. lived a good life. Now watch this, a good life ain't a perfect life. Because ain't nobody in here perfect. There was only one perfect man, and he lived 2,000 years ago. Brother Alston, your family's going to miss you, sir. But I challenge the family to hold on to the good times. When you feel low in your spirit, think about, oh, Donald used to say that. Think about the jokes your dad used to tell you. Think about when he was cooking. Did your dad used to hum when he cooked? That's a good cook when they used to hum. When they used to hum them hymns or something. That's when you're cooking good. When you ain't no other music going on, but you just humming. But think about those good times. And I need to challenge the family too. Listen, life is too fragile.
Yes.
Don't hold on to those ill wills towards each other. Now, I ain't trying to say that every day we're going to sing Kumbaya. But at least learn how to love on each other.
Yes.
Life is too short. It's a messed up feeling to have regrets when your loved one is gone and you ain't speak to them in a long time. Or you have some ill wills towards them. Life itself is too hard. We're dealing with a lot in this world. We don't know if we could go to the Walmart or the supermarket and make it home. And we fighting and bickering with family members? Every day, my wife leave out to work. We pray, and I said, Lord, bring her back home safe. I got 6 beautiful children. 2 are still in college. 4 are grown, and thank be to God they out the house. But the 2 come home, and when they go back to college campus, we anoint them and pray. Yes. Lord, because we don't know.
That's right. Amen.
Those 19 children that went to school and hugged their parents, they thought they were coming back home.
Yes.
Those are your kids right there, young lady. Hug on them. Love them.
Yes.
Pray for them.
Yes.
Let them know, Mommy, love you.
Yes. Amen.
Because we're living in a dangerous world.
Yes.
Dangerous. This man drove all the way from Vegas, and then the other guy up in Buffalo drove 200 miles just to kill. Racist. He's a racist coward. To kill people that was super shopping in this supermarket. The devil is a liar. I asked God to keep my mother. She go in the supermarket. Lord, protect her. Because we don't know. But Brother Donald, you lived a good life. God bless him. February 2nd, 1937, same year my father was born. And he died on this side, May 9th, 2022. At this time, I want everybody to just close their eyes. First, I want to ask you a question. Do you have life insurance? Because believe it or not, I'm a life insurance salesperson. Now, I don't sell it because Jesus done paid it all. But I can tell you, I can offer you a benefit package that will never expire. Because we all got to go down this road one day. But I want to live again. Life is fragile. Handle it with care. You ever see those boxes and you see on this side up and handle with care, fragile? That's how life is. But one day we're going to have to give an account for this life. If you don't know Jesus and the pardon of your sins, and I'm not asking you to be perfect, because being a Christian is not being perfect. We all fall short. We all messed up. Me, preacher, pastor, family man, husband, father, no, I'm not perfect. I messed up. But thanks be to God for the blood of God that covers me. Every single day I ask God, forgive me, Jesus, and help me, Jesus. Help me, Lord. Don't let this collar fool you. Pastor ain't perfect, but I love the Lord. So if there's anybody here today want to say, Pastor, I want to sign up for that benefit package. And all I got to do is give Jesus my heart. No down payment. Nothing. It's been paid with the nails. It's been paid with the scars in his back and his scars and a piercing in his side. Say, Lord, I need you, Jesus. Is there anybody here that just can say, Lord, I need you? Take inventory on your own life, an examination. Give yourself a spiritual an examination. And say, God, I got a nasty attitude. I need some fixing, God. God, I got anger in my heart, God. I need some fixing. Is there anybody here that can say, Lord, fix me, Jesus? Fix me, Lord. I like that. Somebody said, I'm a work in progress. That's so right. We all are work in progress, but God, fix me, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now at this time, I want you to keep your eyes closed. Just those of you that knew our brother Donald personally, think about the good times right about now. Just hear his voice in your ear. Pop used to say this. My dad used to say that. Uncle Donald used to say this. My friend used to say that. Just think about it. We give you 30 seconds to just think about it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Amen. We're living to live again. My name is Pastor Pinckney, and I approve this message. Amen. At this time, we're going to commit this body. Hallelujah, Jesus. Remember, we're going to continue to pray for the family. Don't stop praying. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Amen. You ready? For as much as it pleased the Almighty God to take out of this world the soul of our beloved Donald Alston Sr., we therefore commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for that blessed hope when the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ, that physical death, will we rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet our Lord and Savior in the air. And so shall we be with the Lord forever and ever. So comfort each other with these words. Amen. The family would like to announce that the repast will be announced at a later date. The repast for our brother Donald. Amen. We thank the Lord on today. Our brother Jason, at this time.
Praise God for everyone in attendance. We're going to allow the family and friends on the B side to come this way and they'll shake their hands before we exit. Amen.
New, 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 everything new, 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 everything new. I'm ready to go. I'm ready for more. I'm ready for new. Like a straight out the stove. You already know. I'm ready to flow. I'm ready to move. The whole is still on the pumps. New bag. We still got the dance. You made it alone. Is this
Started me on my way. For letting that said, worship the Lord. I worship him. Come on, he's brought you over some mountains. Come on, tell him thank you. Come on, tell him thank you. That's it, let's worship the Lord. He desires our praise tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless you. Hey!
that my God is. The Lord is
sovereign,
sovereign, sovereign. The Lord is my God. He is sovereign.
What can you?
He can.
I pray we'll find your love.
I pray we'll find your love. it in our heart.
And hold it in our heart.
When stars go out each night.
Stars go out each night.
Remind us where you are.
Remind us where you are.
Let this be our prayer.
Let this be our prayer.
When shadows fill our day. Lead us to a place of mind.
Guide us with your grace.
Guide us with your grace.
Give us faith so we'll.